Assalamu alaikum and hello everyone, the mad programmer here. In today's tutorial we'll be covering escape sequences, and our previous tutorial was on program layouts, in which we discussed code layout, commenting, code indentation, error detection and correction, line number display and breakpoints. If you haven't watched that tutorial, click on the link appearing on the screen or in the description below. In escape sequences, we'll be covering three things: what, why, and how. What are escape sequences? A sequence of characters that does not represent itself when used inside a character or a string literal. Why do we use escape sequences? Simply to perform another function that can't be or is difficult to represent directly. How do we use escape sequences? Simply by adding a backslash along with some variable. Escape sequences are normally used inside single quotes when used alone, such as quote backslash, for example n backslash, and when used in statements we use them inside a double quote, such as shown in the example, double quote hello backslash n double quote. Here's a list of escape sequences we are going to be covering today, such as new line, or you can call it line break, backslash n, the tab, backslash t, backspace, backslash b, cache return. This basically returns the cursor to the start of the line. Formfeed, backslash f. This represents page break but is obsolete now and isn't used. Backslash a. This gives a system bell like a beep sound. For a backslash, simply double backslash, question mark, you can directly use a question mark, or a backslash question mark. For a single quote, backslash quote. For a double quote, backslash double quote. And lastly, the null character, which is represented by a backslash and a zero. Now I'll explain all of these in details. Let's start our compilers. Okay guys, let's get started. Here's a random statement about the mad programmer, the ultimate programming hub. Let's debug it. Okay, as you can see, this whole statement came within one line. Now to make this look neater and make a better layout, we can use escape sequences. I'll teach you guys about the end else syntax. End else stands for end line. It's basically added after an insertion operator followed by a semicolon. This makes the selected code appear on the next line. The ultimate programming hub, new line, tutorials, projects, code, guidance, etc. The whole other statement came in the second line. Now let's get started back on our main topic. I'm going to teach you guys about escape sequences. First of all, I'm going to teach you guys about the new line escape sequence, backslash n. This performs the same function as endl. In escape sequences, we don't need to add the insertion operators. We can write them within the statements. Let's debug the program. As you can see, the ultimate programming hub, the new line, tutorials, projects, code, etc. It worked the same as end line. Now let's make our code a bit neater. Let me debug the program again. Tutorials, projects, code, guidance, problem solving, live discussions, and etc. all came in the new lines. Now let's say I want to add some space between the tutorials, projects, code. I don't want him touching the start of the line. I'm going to add a backslash t for this. It gives a certain amount of space depending on the software we use. It can be 2, 4 or even 8. Let's debug the program. As you can see, tutorials now has a selected amount of space and then it's displayed. Let's do the same for the other points also. I notice escape sequences are very handy if you want to make your code look neater. Okay, let's debug the program again. And voila, it already looks better. Next off, we're going to learn about form feed. This is obsolete, so basically we won't be learning anything in this. When used, it basically gives a weird looking symbol. Let's debug and see. Okay, let's zoom in a bit. As you can see, we got a weird looking symbol on the command prompt. Next off is system alert. Backslash A basically gives a beep or a default system alert sound. Let's debug the program. I got the default system alert sound. Now to display a backslash on our statement, I'll have to use the double backslash escape sequence to display it. This is because a single backslash is read by the compiler as an escape slash. Okay, and the backslashes have now been displayed on our command prompt. Now say if I were to remove one backslash, the compiler won't show the other backslash. Let's debug the program. As you can see, the backslash has now vanished from the starting point, while the other still showed because it had a double backslash. Let me add some space and debug the program again. Now if I want to remove this space without using backspace, I'll simply use the escape sequence backslash B. It's used to remove spaces after it. As you can see, the space has now decreased, but let's add some more backslashes so the difference is more visible. There we go. Now backslashes basically remove the space after it, not before it, which is why when I added more backslashes right now, there was no effect on the output. Okay, now for the question mark. To add a question mark, you simply use the backslash question mark or a simple question mark. They perform the same. Okay, now let's add a backslash over here and see what we get. Let's debug the program and we got the same output. Next off, let's add a single quote to all our points. We're going to use the backslash single quote for it. Let's add the same on the last point also, backslash single quote. Let's debug our program. Now all our points from tutorials to QA sessions are within the single quote. Now let's add double quote on the first line, backslash double quote. Now I'll also add one after the question mark, backslash double quote. Let's debug our program. Now the ultimate programming hub question mark is within the double quotes. Now let's say I want to remove everything after the statement the ultimate programming hub question mark double quote, but I don't want to permanently remove it. I just want it to be hidden. I don't want to show it right now. I'll simply add the null character escape sequence backslash zero. Now you can see everything after the statement has now been hidden on the command prompt. Now let's remove the null character and see what we get. As you can see, everything has now returned. The null character only hides it from the command prompt. It's not a permanent erase, although it is very useful. Now let's add the null character at the starting of the program. After the backslash, let's add the null character. As you can see, everything is now hidden in the command prompt. Now let's go to our final escape sequence, the return cursor. Now for example, if I want the blinking cursor to appear at the front of the starting line, I'm simply going to write backslash R. Let's debug our program. Now the blinking cursor has appeared at the start of the line rather than the end. Now backslash R has its limitations. It can only be used on the last line of the code. The cursor is blinking on the end of the line like before. Now, backslash R basically has its limitations. It can only be used at the last line. Now, for example, if I'm using it on an above line, it'll have no effect on the code. Let's write backslash R before development. As you can see, the cursor is still blinking at the end of the line. And in our next tutorial, we'll be covering user inputs and data types. Guys, if you like this tutorial, please hit the thumbs up button and share with your friends on any social website you use. do comment if you didn't understand anything or if something wasn't clear. I'll reply to each and every comment. And do subscribe to my channel to stay tuned for more upcoming tutorials. Stay tuned for more. YouTube, Facebook, Google, Instagram, and Twitter.